Whether you say Atlantic City, whether you say New York, whether you say Madison Square Garden, or and they really the two big spots if you're not talking about, football or soccer fields or anything like that. We're talking about inside venues, inside historic buildings that, the Madison Square Garden, we hear, right? This is the legacy that the Barclays Center will remember too, just like my fight. They remember this fight, because this fight could have been anywhere. Could have even been out of the country, in Saudi Arabia. You think they wouldn't pay millions of dollars to fuck to get this fight there? As much as they want to be in the business, I'm talking about the Saudis. They would have paid probably double. Who knows, right? They want to be in the game. So being in New York City, Brooklyn, or Crooklyn. Come on, man.
Yeah,
come on. I feel like I'm back in when I fought Trevor's Cloud for the WBA light heavyweight championship at 47. Excuse me. It's crazy.
Bernard, at the face-off at the Empire State Building, as a master,
I wasn't
of,
here.
Of psychological warfare. You saw it, right? So, as a master of psychological warfare, that you were.
A master.
Devin did slap Ryan, but Ryan also got him to the point to react that way, right?
And we haven't seen Devin react that way in really any match that I witnessed him being more of a calm, more of a person that take it on the chin when things are said and things are mentioned. But this particular time, Ryan got a reaction out of him. And to me, that's saying that, somebody didn't know something about getting in the head of your opponent. I mean, I think hands down, people understand that if anybody want to speak on how effective that can be, it's Bernard Hopkins.
I have a question about your Philadelphia brother, Jerome Boutsenis,
I don't want to talk about Boutsenis. I'm going to talk about what's happening now. That's his business. That's his problem. It becomes our business, Golden Boy, when he run into one of our guys. This fight is so important to be distracted by whoever would think that anything else is important, especially talking to a promoter, especially talking to somebody that understands the business, to talk about Bruce Ennis or anybody else and not talk about this historic, important, dramatized fight that's happening this Saturday between Ryan Garcia and Devin Haney.
What's your thoughts on Ryan Garcia, speaking of distractions, and his promotion of the fight? Is it a distraction to, his Twitter rants, the things he's talking about?
They are saying it's a distraction. Until the outcome of Saturday, I'm pretty sure, I'm confident that you will see it was more of a motivation, but it was meant and put out there to be a distraction, because who's talking about it? You. Them, not I. And so I am asking questions about something that Ryan got those who's want to ask me these questions about what he said. So who's being controlled? Who's being led down a whole alley to where they don't even know where they're going, but they just repeating what they seen because they was fed by media content by Ryan Garcia. We all know that all that is out there, but it don't mean nothing when Saturday night come and that bell ring and we all witnessing potentially history or not. That's where the balls will come down to. We less than 72 hours away. Am I right? 48 something, right? Do the math. If you want to count these hours, let's count them. I consider this day is over.
As a fighter, though, you don't think it takes away from the focus?
No.
You are known to lock in on fights.
No, it don't take away the focus, because if you look at things I've said, things I've done prior to the fight, you would be like, man, what Ryan doing is nothing extraordinary or outlandish and outrageous, rather, than what Bernard Hopkins did.
Yeah, but you were
and I'm not even talking about the flag. You know how many Puerto Ricans still hate me today? And I've been to San Juan. That's the only time I lose weight when I go to San Juan, because I don't eat nothing for 3 days. So what are we talking about? We're talking about a strategy, or maybe not, on why and how this could affect either fighter, either person, Devin Haney or and Ryan Garcia. I said that it can motivate both of them to do what they set out to do and say what they're gonna do. But now the clock is ticking. The sand in the sand clock glass is almost over. After a while, it's no rap. When I go up there, when the main event come and Oscar call me up to the podium, I have no rap. There's nothing to talk about. We have a fight, which was questioned 24 hours ago, 48 hours ago, 70 hours ago, going backwards. God knows we ain't gonna talk about last week. We ain't supposed to be here, correct? There's nothing else for me to say other than say thank you and sit down, get your tickets, and I'm done. The shortest conversation I ever had in my life would be in a couple of minutes.
My last question is, have you seen any difference in Ryan since he's been with Derrick James? And if so, what can you kind of comment on that you've seen since he got?
Have I seen anything different since he...
Or improved.
Improved? I believe his attitude improved. I believe what makes him comfortable that we might not understand is not our problems, not his problem, is what he feels comfortable. Have I seen him elevate? Have I seen him improve? Derrick James only been with Ryan Garcia, what? 2 years, year, whatever? I gave him two. So say a year and a half, right? So in a year and a half, Ryan had what, two fights? Two, three fights. He ain't had more than three, correct?
This is his second fight with Derrick James.
Oscar Duarte.
So let me tell you something. The great Emmanuel Stewart had fights. Fighters he had one time, they didn't look like he had them for 2 or 3 weeks. So let's be, if we're gonna, I don't look for fairness, not from people, right? I look for ignorance and I look for understanding. So I'm gonna give you the understanding after the ignorance. They have a chemistry that suits them and feels to Ryan that he can work with James based on the chemistry that they have. And whether he or I think or someone else thinks that he is not learning or he's not looking different than he did before James is unfair question. And I'd be a fool to try to say yes or no. I can just say, give it a little bit of time. They only been together for two fights. Out of fairness, I mean, you know, if fairness exists in this world, let's see what happens as time go on. I'm not saying 2 years. I'm not saying 3 years. I'm saying when he fight Saturday. And when, not if, he wins Saturday and he gets another big fight. You don't go down from fights like this, you go up. That's why he wanna get right back in the race. We gotta give a guy of any sports, especially boxing, take away the fight after the Tank fight. That was a warm-up. We all know what that was. I look at this from Tank to Devin Haney. Well, Bernard, you know he fought the guy. I don't want to look at that. I look at that as getting to see if I really want. That was just a little blow the dust off. Still got to be careful and respectful. It's still a fighter. Still need to be respectful. Or we wouldn't be here, correct?
Yeah.
So look at Tank fight straight to Devin Haney. Who does that in boxing? They ducking everybody.
What you think he learned from the Tank fight to this fight?
Not to get hit. And to keep people out of his camp that he don't know. And even watch the people you do know even more. It's lessons in everything.
Does Ryan have the fastest left hook, you think, in boxing right now?
No, my sister Bernadette does. Bernard,
what have you thought of when he talks about I might fight a gear or break a shoulder? We've seen things happen in big fights. Bo Galata, Holyfield, Tyson.
You think he gonna tell, did Tyson tell you he was gonna bite Holyfield's ear?
No, he didn't.
Let's talk about the fight. I don't want to talk about ear biting. I don't want to talk about any stuff that, you know. far as I'm concerned, it's commercial for a conversation that takes away of, it's a distraction. Let Devin Haney be distracted. I hope he weren't about coming to wear earmuffs. Let Devin Haney be distracted.
Well, he's promising a knockout and meeting Ryan in the center ring.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing. But I'm saying he never says things like that. To your point, is that Ryan getting him to change his game plan a little bit?
We'll see.
Bernard, you've been visiting Ryan during this training camp. How does he look?
Looks great. He looks great. Looks focused. He looks great when it comes to combinations and the punches. And also, I see that he's focused. I see his focus. He's looking at me when I talk to him. He's looking at his trainer when I'm talking to him. And he has to take that same energy and that same demeanor for the next 2 days into the fight. Because, look, Ryan been in the amateurs. He's traveled basically the world. He's been around all kinds of fighters, all kinds of personalities. I'm not saying he's a veteran, but he's not a rookie in controlling his fight mode emotions. Fight mode emotions. We all have them. We're getting ready for war. And if you don't look at it that way, you're in the wrong damn business. Young, old, or in the middle of boxing, or say as a fighter, that's the mentality. And listen, if they listen to this videos of all these resources that interviewing me right now, if they wasn't thinking that, they're going to be thinking that once they see this interview.
Fans are concerned if Ryan's going to make weight. Is there a fine?
Who said that?
Fans. There's been fans that expressed that they're
concerned. I can't. Fans said that this is Santa Claus. Come on, man. You want a conversation. Fan says, we got to have talk about, we got to answer or at least get some questions about something that makes sense.
Well, I want
fan to says that he looks like. That fan could be in Europe. That fan could be on Mars. That fan could be anywhere. Why entertain us a waste of time?
Well, I want to ask you this, Champ.
How do you feel? How do the person that's delivering the message, which is the messengers, who always get the bad end of the stick,
okay, well,
never sign them to be the messenger.
I'm glad you asked, bro.
How do you feel or see or think when you see Ryan working with his shirt off and you see Devin Haney working with two shirts, correct?
Right. Well,
who look like who's trying to smother the body and let the heat marinate and hopefully sweat? You think we don't know that game? You think a fighter, an experienced reporter don't know what that means? A guy with no shirt on got weight problems, and a guy with two shirts on don't have weight problems. Duh. You don't need any degree from any university to at least make an educated guess that who looks like they're trying to lose weight. If that's even a conversation. If y'all cut this out, y'all cut out. I didn't bring this up. I'm pointing. He did. He fucking did. That guy right there.
But Bernard, is that speculation fair where Devin Haney, maybe something normal in the boxing week with two shirts on, but what's not normal?
That's not normal.
But well, for some people it may be normal.
Well, maybe because he's in Vegas and he here. It's probably real cold here to him. But I don't know. I just know the old tricks of the trade. I never had a problem with weight. 4 pounds over my fighting weight when I fought 7 years ago. I'm literally 4 pounds. I got on the scale today. So I have no problem with that, but I've been around situations where the landing of a plane, when they tell you we 30 miles away and get all your goods and get all your stuff and make sure that everything in your seatbelt is on and they make a landing, correct? Now they tell you these things because they don't know if the landing is gonna be rough or hard, but in boxing you do know what you're weighing around this time, less than 72 hours from the fight. You know what you're weighing. So if you need to shed off something or break a good sweat, guess what you're gonna do? You're gonna wear a coat, jacket, Abilene, lotion, Vaseline. Come on, man, you've been around this game.
And my point, Bernard, is if it's okay to question those things, why is it not okay to question Ryan Garcia being thrown out of the next game or the things that he's been posting?
Because you know why? You know why? You know why? Because they heard he really don't like the Mets and they don't want to go ahead and give him a Mets shirt. They did that to them. They did that to me before. Not here, but you know what I mean? Philadelphia. I mean, we had a bad team.
Well, Bernard, I think there is.
Don't you think he's causing us to have the questions that we are here asking and the concerns for those of us that have followed Ryan for the last 5 or 6 years?
I think he in your head. I think he in your head. I think he in your head.